expensive camera sling bag that I own. This is the Oberworth Photo Backpack Sling. Let's get right into it. Hey everyone, welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Desmond. I make content about tech and travel gear, and one of the favorite topics that I like to talk about is camera slings, and this is among the newest camera sling that I have in my arsenal that I've been testing over the last few weeks. And there's a few things that are unique about this. First of all, the shape and the design. The second is the price tag. This thing comes in at a whopping $649 before tax. So let's talk about what it is and if it's worth it. First of all, this is from a company called Oberworth. And if there are any of you that are familiar with the camera bag space, Oberworth is a well-known brand for making incredibly high-quality camera bags. And it goes without saying that high quality sometimes comes with a pretty high price tag. And that is true for the Oberworth Photo Backpack Sling. So let's take a quick walk around the bag. So as you can see here, the shape is pretty interesting. And what I like about it is it's actually quite ergonomic. It's nice to wear on the body. And I think overall, this looks great when you are carrying it out and about. The size is also pretty substantial. It holds a mirrorless camera and a large lens with room for an additional lens and other accessories. Things that I like about this are these little pockets that sit on the outside, and we'll go through each of those one by one. Generally speaking, the build quality on this is incredible. The material itself, the primary material that is a high quality German leather. This whole bag is handmade, which is fantastic. And then the zippers also have a really nice, smooth pull to them. If you've had cheaper bags in the past, or if you've ever used bags with just grippy, terrible zippers, you are one that will appreciate just the smoothness of a nice set of zippers. The leather here itself is pebbled. I really like it. I think it's nice compared to, say, a smoother leather, which tends to scratch a little bit more often. This pebbled leather does not. I'm scratching it right now. I know some of you may cringe, but it's something that will not show wear and tear as easily as, say, a smooth leather. The other thing I'll talk about is it is hybrid material. So if you look at the back here, I'll give you a nice close look. You've got this breathable kind of neoprene material. It's a synthetic finish. This is the stuff that sits against your back or your hip as you are wearing it. So it's not leather on body. It's this nice breathable mesh material, which is great. And I'll just give you a nice look here. We've got some polished hardware as well as this frog style clip. I'll show you that in a second. And same thing on this side. These are the little bolts that hold in the strap. Now, before I open it up, let's talk about some of these smaller pockets. First of all, let's take a look here. We've got the side pocket. I'm gonna go ahead and open that up. Check out the interior of this. Oberworth is also known for making bags with this beautiful red interior. They tend to kind of go hand in hand with the Leica brand, which is, again, the aesthetic and the price range for these bags tend to sit well within the Leica world and those types of buyers. But you can see inside this really nice red interior that sets it apart from some of the other leather bags that I've tested in the past. I actually really like these external pockets because one opens outward like this and the other opens inward like this. So the design is actually really quite nice. So when you flip it over to the front, you can open this inward and you can grab your stuff. Or if you pull it over here, you can get your things. I actually use this to hold a wallet, spare batteries. This will fit an ND filter. Anything tiny that you want easy access to, these pockets are actually great for. And other camera slings that I've had, like the Ona Rockaway Sling and some of the other bags, don't have these external pockets. I actually really like them. Continuing around pockets, let's talk about this big one on the front. Like I mentioned, just really smooth and easy zipper pull. For sling bags, what I'd like is just to be able to pull this over to the front and just glide zippers open so I can easily access my stuff. But you've got a pocket here. You can put your different dongles, lens pens, just any other accessories you need to carry and you would like easy access to. I really like this particular bag just because it's got these three additional pockets. Whether or not that warrants the $650 price tag, I think it is up to the buyer, but I enjoy the convenience of having these three pockets for all of my little accessories when I am carrying my camera gear. All right, so let's get to the main compartment here. I'm gonna give you a close look. The zip is really quite nice. And that's the thing that's important about this particular bag, because it has these rounded edges. If the zippers weren't as nice, it would be really hard getting around this corner. So we'll open this up and you can see here, we have a really nice bright interior. I've actually got the Oberwerth dust bag that came with it. I just keep it in here so it holds its shape, but the dust bag is really nice. And then we've got the strap itself. Let me give you a close look at the strap. You can see here, it's this interesting and unique frog clip style. I don't know if any of you have used this type of clip in the past. I actually really like it. You can find it on like tactical belts and like heavy duty military-esque products, but this is a frog clip and I'll show you how it works. So as you can see here, the frog clip works great. It clicks right into place and then it's kind of got this easy, quick detach situation going. The thing to call out about this particular clip is it is very heavy duty. I think it's what, a Cobra clip. Other companies call it a frog clip. It doesn't really matter. It's this particular style that makes it a very heavy duty type of clip. You have to push up on the two teeth here to release it. And once it locks into place, it's really not going anywhere. Sometimes I think for clips like this, this might be a little bit over-engineered or maybe too heavy duty for a bag like this. You're not carrying tons and tons of weight, but this thing is pretty insane. I like how heavy duty it is. Oberwerth, I think in their product photos, have someone hanging from a tree with this like wrapped around them. So you know the strap can hold the weight of a human being. Probably over-engineered, but again, not like you don't want the extra safety of having a really well-structured, heavy-duty bag that can handle any type of like weight that you put on it, since you're gonna be placing a multi-thousand dollar camera in this bag. But what I will say is, regardless of the clip style, even though I really like this, the fact that you can clip and unclip this is important for me. I have camera slings where the strap is permanently secured to the bag itself, and that has its pros and its cons. And that's one nice thing, is if I've got it on my body and I want to just take the bag off, I can remove the clip and, you know, reclip it over the shoulder or reclip it over my chest, and you can hear that really satisfying click. That has maintained itself, so that satisfying crispy click hasn't gone away yet. The other reason why I like a removable clip like this is if I'm out and I'm traveling and I'm at a restaurant or I'm somewhere, I want to wrap this around the chair or the leg of the table so that it's secure, so when I'm eating, no one can come and just pull the camera bag away from me. All right, so let's skip past the clip and let's talk about the inside. Again, as you can see, that red interior. This is a felt, soft, microfiber-like material, very different than this, which is kind of a smooth lining. In here, everything is soft because this is where your camera gear goes, your lenses, your bodies. What you'll find up here are these three little black pieces. This is just a Oberwerth logo with the external leather. These two are actually little SD card pockets. So that's kind of nice. You've got SD card pockets. You can place your additional memory cards here. And then inside, you're going to see the space. What I actually really like about this is the odd shape. So you've kind of got that angular setup here, and it makes it really nice to place your camera in. So here I've got my A7 R5 with the 24-70 G Master Mark II from Sony. And normally when I'm carrying this out and about, I've got the camera bag and I will just place it in here like that. So you can see it fits. This is one of my largest setups. I don't carry a lens larger than the 24-70, which is already relatively large. It fits in here really well, and it makes taking it in and out really convenient. So it's not a squished fit. It's actually really quite nice. And then on the other side, what you're going to notice is I've got another flap here. This is where I can place an additional lens. I'll probably put a 35 millimeter 1.4 G Master or like my 85 millimeter Batis. So you can fit an additional lens here and the 24 to 70 with the A7 R5. The nice thing too is I like Oberwurz flaps because they've kind of got a top. So if you put your lens in here, you can push that over and kind of protect it a little bit more. Or if you have smaller objects and smaller things like, you know, an action camera, extra batteries, things you don't want to kind of fall out, you can put them in here and you can close the flap as well. It's really nice and convenient. It comes with additional flaps. I'm only using one because I like to carry my big setup. Another way you can do this is, let's just say we put it in the opposite way. I've got my A7 R5 and the 24 to 70 facing the other way where the lens is now inside. You can put the flap over here and you can place things on top. So the top of your lens is also protected. I really like this. I thought it was a thoughtful addition. And again, probably one of the reasons why Oberwurz is so well known for making high quality, well designed, yet expensive bags. The other thing I'll actually show you is there's an internal zipper. So I can go ahead and slide that open and I have a whole other pocket inside. So if you're kind of using this as a one and done travel day sling, you've got your camera bag, your extra lens, you've got some batteries, SD cards. In this hidden pocket inside, you could put your passport, you can put cash, wallet, other things that you want protected inside this additional pocket. And this smooth zipper means I can pull this around this corner relatively easy and just close the bag up. So that's one thing that's really important. It's got this weird shape and the zipper runs all the way around this corner to the back. If it was a less smooth zipper, it would actually be really quite a pain to work with because you kind of got to fidget around this angle, but really it's so smooth to get this thing open. And I really enjoy that. So let's get down to the big question. Is this bag worth $649 before tax? It's gonna be a tough one to sell. I personally do think it is, solely based on a few important factors. One, yes, you are paying for the build quality and the materials. They are high-end, they are expensive, so the cost of production is higher than your standard Peak Design sling or even some of the new Ona sling bags. Ona is also known for being an expensive brand in the camera bag space, but their new leather bags are so thin to cut down on weight, but you can tell that like the amount of material is way reduced. This is actually a really high quality leather. The lining is really well made. Everything about the materials are well done. So I think the production cost here makes sense. Design wise, I actually think the design is great. Again, when it comes to some of these higher end leather camera bags, they tend to over index on like quality of the material and the simple design aesthetic. So you're really just getting this relatively simple leather slab. Not to say that's not everyone's vibe, but it tends to lack functionality and features and pockets because that doesn't look high-end. I think Oberwurz did a really good job of injecting a lot of functionality into this bag, like these outside pockets, in a way that still feels relatively elevated and doesn't take away from the quality of the brand itself. So it doesn't look too much like a tech bag, but it doesn't look like, you know, a leather slab that doesn't have a lot of features or functionality to it, making it a less functional camera bag. I think this has a good mix of all those things. And a good example of that is this like Cobra slash Frog clip, whatever we call it, right? I don't really see this style of clip often on high-end bags, but I know that this is like industrial quality stuff. It is very heavy duty. This is a clip that will not fail or break on you. There's the amount of metal and structure that goes into a clip like this. And I think the first time I've ever come across this was, it's usually like military supply stores. They use these types of clips because they're functional, they're quick, and they are incredibly heavy duty. So it's interesting to see this on a like high quality brand like this. I know the strap is incredibly sturdy as well. So it's a good mix of quality, function. For most of you that are watching, probably don't spend $650 on a camera sling. You could get a nice lens for that. You could get a cheap camera body. But what I want you to keep in mind is that Oberworth tends to market to a Leica buyer. A lot of their marketing and advertising is around like the SL line of Leica cameras. So that type of buyer is already spending way more money on a camera body, and this would be like 10% of that. So if you're spending $6,000-$7,000 on a Leica SL setup, what's 10%, a $600 sling bag that protects that investment? That's what I want you to keep in mind when you're watching something like this. This is designed for a different type of buyer. And if you are a Leica buyer, like, this might be right up your alley. As a Sony user, this is a huge bonus. It's a real nice to have, because usually I carry my Sony in different bags, like the Ona Rockaway sling or like a Peak Design sling. But this is a really, really nice bag. Not all of you should spend your money on it, but if you've got the cash to burn, you're, you know, someone who really appreciates like Oberworth as a brand, this is a solid buy. With that said, if you like content like this, hit that like button, subscribe for more videos. I'll keep testing this and I'll tell you how I feel about it in about 6 months. All right, catch you in the next one.